listening to The Sauce, recorded live in the FingerLicks1.com studios, deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York, featuring Dandy, Aaron D, Mysterious Taco Girl, Only Sometimes, and Saucy Joe.
Mic check.
And now,
mic check.
Good evening, Saucepods listeners, wherever you may be in space or time. It's me, Tony Sometimes, and this is episode number 92 of the Sauce Podcast, recorded live in the studios of FingerLicks1.com, deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York. It's Tuesday, March 5th, 2013, and tonight we'll be talking about what's going down in El Cajon, California. A gobsmacked delivery man in London. Our tweet of the week, our weekly recommendations, Dandy's choice, and much, much more. Per usual, I'm joined up here in the FingerLicks1.com studios tonight with my saucy compañeros, Dandy, Aaron D.
It's awkward Tuesday.
And Mysterious Taco Girl.
It's Tuesday.
And Saucy Joe.
I can confirm that it is Tuesday, and it's odd to be here.
Have we ever done a show that wasn't on a Tuesday?
Everyone.
They're all.
Oh. Have we ever done a show that wasn't on a Monday, our normal time? Have we ever done an off Monday show? I think we have.
Yeah, I think we have.
We did a Friday one.
Two.
Huh.
Well, we've done Fridays. I don't think we've ever done a Tuesday.
It is odd. One day closer to the weekend, though, right, guys?
I'm working for it.
Now, I did mention wherever you may be in space or time tonight because some people don't watch this live. So if you're listening to this like on recorded or downloaded onto your iPod or sometime, you know, maybe tomorrow or the next day, you're in the future right now. You are living in the future. Think of that. So I watched a movie this weekend, Moonlight Kingdom. Familiar with it?
Moonrise Kingdom.
Moonrise Kingdom, yeah. I'm not going to recommend that movie.
Good, huh?
Not going to recommend it. It was okay, but
and you remember the title.
It's not going to be recommended by me tonight. But
it just sounds like it would be stupid.
What was it about?
I didn't say it was stupid.
It's got a moon in it, and Danny doesn't like space.
It sounds stupid. Stupid.
It just sounds like a stupid movie.
What, did they use money to make a movie about the moon?
Stupid.
Where they could have used it to clean up the streets?
That's right.
Here on Earth.
Could have had all the street signs changed.
Old terrestrial Dandy.
Nothing to do with the moon. It was all right. I wouldn't say it was stupid. Just wouldn't recommend it.
You're not going to.
No.
We should get you to wear one of those moon helmets, like the globe.
We'd love that.
Fuck that.
Well, it'd be funny.
We'll put the mic right in there with you.
Put a fake fish in there.
Stupid.
That is stupid. I'd get all claustrophobic. What if my breath smelled?
You're only offending yourself, my friend.
You can't smell your own bad breath.
If you're in a fucking helmet?
I don't know about that.
I'm not sure you can.
There's got to be some people in this world that can smell their own bad breath, because it's bad sometimes.
I have a friend that claims she can, like, breathe it up to her nose. She does, like, a sniff thing.
I can do that.
I can't.
Everybody make the face.
I can't do that.
But you got to sniff at the same
time. Well, it's just like a French inhale. It's the same theory.
Yeah, but that you kind of like let it linger.
Or
you don't really have to.
Not like you've ever done that. I'm just saying. That's the same theory. You just push the air out of your mouth. You're not breathing out your mouth.
She does.
You're
like
actually
a,
breathing in through your nose and pushing the air out of your mouth.
It's a really obvious, but all at the same time.
Huh, sounds like your friend doesn't know about the food chain.
I think it's an odd trick.
Your friend is a grade A moron.
Most of the time.
Very judgmental tonight.
I'm sorry. I've been thinking about The Simpsons all day, and it just came to me.
Most of the time, folks that suffer from chronic halitosis don't even know they're afflicted.
No.
They have to, because that shit could fucking peel paint.
Until somebody tells them.
I don't think you know.
Yeah,
like
you
when
do
you're
not.
Laying in bed and your face is on the pillow, like half your mouth is on the pillow, when you breathe out, you can smell that shit sometimes.
Oh, it's you.
Yeah, he says you.
No one's offended. Well,
yeah, I don't get it. I've never smelled my own breath.
You probably should sometimes.
I think I have. At work, when you have the glass up.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You don't have the glass up?
It doesn't work.
That's a case of when I have dealt it, but have not smelt it.
Correct. I think it's time we had an intervention.
But
bad breath is horrible.
I would want somebody to tell me. You know, that's a difficult thing, is that you know, let's say you want to judge your attractiveness. You know, let's say you're an eighth grader or something. You're like, am I good looking or not?
Like,
you know,
yesterday.
Yeah. You're never going to get an honest answer from somebody. You know, and I guess it's kind of subjective based on the different people, but
yeah,
I would think if I asked my...
There are some things that nobody's
going to
be honest.
Who's going to tell you, Dan, your mom?
No. If you think, if you have a good friend,
you got to ask
hope,
one of
you would hope.
You got to ask one of your friends that's a girl that's really bitchy. You know what I mean? That just tells it like it is. It doesn't care what anybody else thinks.
Whenever you want me to smell your breath, I'm
exactly.
All about
like
it.
Like Mysterious Taco Girl, for instance.
I'm going to lick the end of your nose so you have to walk around with it. Whatever it smells disgusting. Like.
You could get an honest opinion from somebody if you... I know someone in particular who I could ask. Just because she's that type of girl.
I think I know... Do I know who
you have of? People that you would...
You probably know her, yeah.
Oh. The person I was thinking of, I really know.
Oh, she would also...
Do you have people you would tell the truth to and people you would lie to?
Yes.
Yeah, I think everyone does,
it depends on what you mean
it?
By lie, like... What kind of lie are we talking about?
No, it's not that
bad. We're talking
bad.
About if they ask me how attractive they are? Yeah.
Are we like, serious? Like somebody asks you a serious question.
Straight up, Saucy Joe, I want you to tell me, man. I'm really doubting myself lately. And, you know, I'm looking in the mirror for hours. And I just, am I good looking or am I bad looking?
I would give you my opinion.
But you would.
See, I think
I
think we got to stick with the breath thing because good looks, I mean, everyone's different.
Right, that's what I'm saying. I could give you my assessment of how attractive you are, but that's not to say that everyone else feels that
way. You're saying in that case of the bad breath or, well, you know what, if I ask somebody, hey, man, I want you to tell me the truth. Do I have bad breath? I would say, yeah, you know, honestly, you do. But if it was somebody that
why would you lie to someone at that
yeah,
point?
Yeah, I wouldn't lie about that. But something like, you know, am I a good-looking guy?
Yeah.
You know, am I a good-looking guy or do I look like a you know, nerd? Is my nose
it's subjective. No, it's not. Your nose is not big.
No, my nose isn't big at all.
I wouldn't lie to you. No.
So, it's just human nature. We are living in a sea of lies. Didn't we talk about that before? How many times the average person probably lies a day?
I'd be interested to know that.
Well, the answer is 479 times.
No way.
No. I don't even talk to people.
That was his 477th right there.
That's right.
He's got two more tonight.
I don't even talk to people 477 times a day.
That's another lie.
No, I just pulled that number out of my ass, but I bet you a lot.
It's another lie. There's lies everywhere.
No, I did pull that number out of my ass.
And
I didn't talk literally.
See what I'm saying?
I didn't literally, but yeah, you're lying all the time. You don't even know. You're lying to yourself sometimes. Yeah.
I didn't just lie. I do not talk to 479 people a day.
Doesn't say that you talked to 749 people, said that, or whatever we said. It's that you talked to people that many times. Not that many different people.
I mean,
probably, maybe not. Depends. Is every statement considered one?
1.65 lies a day.
Nice.
Where did you just look that up?
PsychologyToday.com.
Wow. Well, that's less than I was predicting.
Is that a website?
That says something about you.
Well, how about this?
I definitely lie more than that.
What's there to lie about on a daily basis?
How you doing today, Tony? Good. Lie.
Right. Yeah, like when I said I was vibrant when I came in? No.
Yeah.
Lie.
Danny said he was feeling vibrant. Yeah. I knew that was a lie. I called him on it.
You looking forward to so-and-so? Sure. Lie.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's two. Now you're above average. Your 0.4 lies above average. I wonder how many times I lie a day. I'm going to try it.
We should keep track.
You got to catch yourself. Cause you.
It goes up exponentially if you have children. I lie to my son all day long.
That can't count. If you're going to count, you can't count that.
Okay. Then I'll.
I try not to lie to my daughter.
Yeah, but you got
to. I don't think I do.
At some point.
It's impossible for me not
to. I think I rarely do. I'm wondering if I ever have. Because I make it a point not to. Because someday, Tony, sometimes daughter's going to come to me with a serious question.
Yep.
She's going to want a straight skinny, mm-hmm. and she knows that her dad doesn't lie to her. So she'll say, Dad, am I attractive? or not?
Is my nose big?
Is my nose
no,
big?
But it might be. It may be a serious question, and I'll give her an honest answer.
Now, men lie 1.93 lies
course,
a day,
we lie
and
more.
Women lie 1.39 lies a
of
day.
Course.
I wonder what they classify as a lie, because I think there's tons of small lies. You know.
Yep.
I don't know if it says that.
My son asked me what the lumps in his scrotum were the other day. What are these? He said.
Would you, little jelly bean seeds?
Yeah.
Is that what you told him?
No, I told him they were jelly beans.
Oh, you did not.
No, I told him they were his testicles. And he said, what are they for? I said, just ignore them. They're not for anything right now. Just
don't
ignore them.
Don't flick them.
You won't need them for a while.
Flick them?
They're useless to you is what I said.
Right now, they're your most vulnerable point.
Just ignore them.
Somebody could take you out.
They're useless to you.
How did he ask you?
He was
just like point to him?
He was in the tub. He's like jamming it all around. That's what he does in the tub. Kid never stops with his incessant
boy,
fiddling.
Leave them balls alone.
I said, stop playing with yourself, boy. And he's like, Dad, what are these bumps? And I go, those are your testicles. They're in your scrotum.
They're right inside your ball sack.
Yeah, those are your balls.
And they're inside your ball sack.
And they're in your
those
sack.
Your balls.
That's there. That's holding your balls.
Oh, I hope he goes to school and he's like, look at my testicles.
There's some parents that would be like so proud. My boy found his balls.
Yeah. It's great.
It's a rite of passage for any man.
That early?
It's inevitable. Like,
early for finding his balls?
If you haven't found your balls at this point, give me a break.
Or how about the dad that looks at his kid and says, I think my kid's got some pretty big balls.
Yeah.
You know, oh, I think there's definitely
look at the size of the balls in that kid.
Yeah. Well, it must be genetic because my balls are big.
I have huge balls. My balls are bigger than the average male's balls. That's weird. He asked my wife about her business, too, and she told him it was like a tube. So now he's like, what's up with that straight tube, he said today.
You'll find out, son.
Straight tube.
It's an interesting way to look at it.
It's like a tube. Kind of, she said it's kind of like a tube. And it kind of is like a tube.
It is absolutely a tube.
Really?
I believe it's
pretty much a tube.
Actually leads into the fallopian tubes.
Yeah.
It's almost like a
tube.
Well, like the... The scientific beaker things. What are they called?
It's like a graduated cylinder.
Exactly.
Sure. Not as rigid, though, thankfully. Good talk,
oh,
good talk.
God.
Tried the old Dollar Shave Club razor. Works like a charm, as you can see.
Yeah, you look good.
Very
no pain.
But I wouldn't lie to you about that. You look good right now.
No pain and clean shave. And so I've just saved myself about $10 a month and a lot
damn.
Of going to the store.
It's $120 a year.
Yeah, even if I'm like in the store, I don't even got to go into that aisle anymore. Nope.
There's nothing
there's
for
nothing
you there.
In there.
There's nothing for you there.
Not anymore. DollarShaveClub.com. And that,
do
I guess.
Do they send you shaving cream, too?
No, I will need shaving cream, I suppose. But that usually lasts longer than the razors. But sir,
does a man have to shave with shaving cream every time?
Oh, yeah. Oh, boy.
Not at all.
Oh, God. It hurts if you don't, though. By the way, Dollar Shave Club can now be totally official. Head to toe, that. That shit comes recommended.
Shave yourself head to toe?
Sometimes. Head to toe, that comes recommended by Tony sometimes.
Shave himself head to toe, and he recommends it.
I'd use one razor on my toes.
Just your toes? You got hairy toes?
You shave your toes?
He's like a hobbit.
No, but if I did.
Oh, well, yeah. If I did, I probably would do too.
Delphi likes to break... Sorry. Dandy likes to break his toe out at parties.
Really?
Sometimes.
You're a toe party guy? I've never seen that. Mm.
Really?
It's weird.
You've never seen my big toe.
We'll have to do that.
I think I have.
Episode we
can't wait to party with
drink.
You next time.
Any action in the chat room, Dandy?
Yeah, they're going at it in there.
Oh, yeah?
Who?
What do they got to say? They probably want to be part of the show, but you're denying
them.
They're
having their own conversation.
About what?
Somebody saying...
we want to be part of their conversation.
Let me get back to it.
Okay. Take your time.
Are you aware that shim is a common term for transvestite?
And who's in there? Shimbashi and Roger?
Roger, Lester, Sequester.
It's quite a crew.
Yeah. Shimbashi's saying you can lick his mangina.
Okay.
A lot of action in the chat room.
Lester said your name makes me think of a transvestite league at Rumseyville where they can't pronounce Bachi correctly.
Doesn't even make sense either.
Shimbashi.
There's no transvestite Bachi
Shimbashi
league.
Shimbashi shaves with olive oil.
Well, that pretty much solidifies who that guy is.
Well, suppose it's way past overdue that we find out what's going on here tonight in terms of drinks.
White man drink like that and he don't eat. He is going to die. We save hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast.
Bet, babe. Slide a piece of the porter. Kickstarter, run the job.
Look at here.
Dandy. Aaron D., what are you drinking tonight?
I have vitamin water. Triple X.
What flavor?
Triple X.
Triple X.
Triple X is a flavor?
It's a flavor, yeah, sure.
That's usually a sign for poison.
It's the... I see.
Or pornography.
I was gonna
say blueberry pomegranate.
Well, that porn water taste.
You see three X's on a something you're going to drink, that usually means poison.
That's all the sheets after they film porn movies. They wring out the sheets into.
It was right next to the black water.
What's black water? All that dirt
black
water?
Water.
That stuff's gross.
Why would you want black water?
We had
Those
that.
Those people
in
are
here.
Idiots.
Did we have that in here? Did someone drink that in here that one day?
No.
Where did I have that water? It's like filtered through dirt, through mud,
no.
moss.
No.
Can't taste good.
It's from the lady on the Housewives show from New Jersey. It's her son's.
Teresa?
I don't know which one it goes.
I'm talking about something else. I'm talking about something else.
But it's black water.
Yeah, because it's
and
got
the name
these crazy minerals in it.
No, it's just black.
No, nobody just drinks black water
All
because
right,
it's
I'm
black.
I'm going to look it up right now. It's just black. There's nothing different.
Yes, so. There is. You're a bonehead.
I heard
Saucy Joe, what are you drinking?
Drinking black water. It's just black. This is an Angry Orchard cider thing that someone left at my house.
Alcoholic cider?
Yep. It's a hard cider. It's crisp apple. It's naturally gluten-free because the young man is... has a gluten allergy, so he left these after he drank some of them.
So if you have that gluten thing,
yep.
you can't drink beer.
Not most beer, yeah.
It's weird.
They make sorghum beer that's gluten-free. It's gross, though. Kind of gross.
What's sorghum?
Like another kind of grain or whatever.
This website may be harmful to your computer.
But also, like, I think a lot of liquors, I know vodka doesn't
grain.
Contain gluten, yeah.
Or, yeah.
As long as, I don't know, I drink potato vodka anyway. Anyway.
Worst affliction, gluten or nut allergy? Dandy, go.
What?
would you rather be afflicted with gluten allergy or nut allergy?
You can't play it. That's my game.
Gluten. Mm. I'll jump in line.
I don't know what either of them are.
Hands
gluten.
Down.
I'd rather have gluten, yeah. Gluten.
Oh, you'd rather have gluten than nuts? Nuts
I'd
allergies
rather have
are
a
more
gluten
allergy devastating.
Than
I don't
a
want a nut
allergy.
Right,
everything
I agree.
Is processed
yep.
with nuts.
I'm with you there.
It's hard to deal
no,
with.
No, peanut butter is way better than bread.
And, well, and the
and Doritos.
Correct.
they're made
yeah,
with
you
peanuts.
You can get gluten-free
Yeah,
bread.
But you can get gluten-free anything.
That's right.
It just
you can't
taste
get
as
you
good.
Can't get peanut-free peanut butter.
Exactly.
Well.
I
You probably can. It's probably made from soy.
I win.
I eat almond
you
butter like
get
every
soy
day.
I finally
so.
Said something smart. I win.
You're the winner, Danny. How's that black water treating
it's,
you?
Let's get him a crown.
Looking like I'm the right one and you're the wrong one.
Okay.
This is what it says. Don't worry. Black water isn't actually sludge. It's just water enhanced with humic and fulvic acid.
Exactly, bonehead. It's got other
Super
things
yum.
In it.
But it's not fucking... It doesn't go through dirt, jackass.
All water goes through dirt. That's where water comes from.
Well, isn't it a form? Doesn't it go through like rock?
Do you think they're sitting at their house, like at their tap, filling up these water bottles? Where do you think that comes from?
That's where most water comes from.
No, but they don't have a bucket of water and dump, or a bucket of dirt and dump the water through
it's
it.
Not, it's not. They put folic acid in it, though.
That's
and
where
put,
the humic
no,
acid.
Fulvic.
Comes. Humic.
The humic one's right.
Look that up.
Bio.
What it is.
Look that up in your funkin' Wagnalls.
Change of dead organic matter.
Right. That organic matter, you know what that is?
Electrolytes,
Andy?
Antioxidants, and so on.
That's the stuff I was talking about. It's actually kind of, it's got a weird little taste to it.
Yeah, humic acid is...
what is it?
Soil.
Yeah, see? Soil.
Fuck you.
According to Wikipedia.
I win! I'm the winner!
It was in an Emmy.
Don't worry,
bag.
Dandy, you're really good looking.
That's a lie.
I'm serious, Tiger Girl, what are, you, what are you drinking?
Dunkin' Donuts coffee, cream and sugar.
How many? Nice. What is that, just cream and sugar?
Yeah.
So that's two cream and two sugars.
I couldn't...
Is that what
Convert.
We decided?
Three sugars.
Damn. I think.
That's crazy.
Tony Sometimes here.
Shimbashi is
checking
drinking
in.
Bong water.
that is humic acid.
I believe that.
I'm drinking a medium coffee with cream one sugar from the Dunk, delivered by Mysterious Taco Girl. I was a little up against it tonight, and I made a quick phone call. Got the coffee brought to me.
Delivery.
So appreciate that.
Not DiGiorno's.
No.
If I run the job.
Look at here.
Man drink like that and he don't eat. He is going to die.
So today on the radio I heard.
It's pronounced radio.
It's probably a lie.
P. Diddy and Mark Wahlberg started their own water.
They started their own
there's
water.
Anything that nobody knows anything about water, it's P. Diddy and Mark Wahlberg.
Got it.
I just don't. I mean, do we really need another water?
They were sitting at a basketball game. Like, man, what are we doing?
It's less about us getting water and them more about them making money. You know, we're going to get water either way. It's whether it's P. Diddy's water or Poland Springs water. We're going to get some
there's
water.
There's a or type of person out there that looks and says, if I'm going to be drinking water, it's going to be P. Diddy water.
You don't think
I got to have this.
It's a brand I most represent myself with.
But you don't think people buy water according to taste? Like, to me, water tastes different, so I buy the water that I think tastes the best. Because it only makes sense.
You think that P. Diddy and Mark Wahlberg are going to market an inferior product that doesn't taste good?
Well, I don't think, what is it, Ciroc Vodka? Is that
okay. Right, yeah. I mean, those guys are always like, having a great time.
That's not the new Grey Goose or whatever the fancy, you know what I mean?
No, they try.
You can't do that good with that.
No, I imagine he'll fail with this one too because it's a stupid idea.
He can afford to fail.
I mean, but why put all that money into something that is just stupid?
Because he gets a chance to work with Mark Wahlberg, man. Mm-hmm. Feel the vibration.
Say hi to your mother for me.
It's such a good vibration.
Come on.
I think that was my second concert.
You actually
I was in
saw
college.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
And we used to do Me and a friend of mine used to have bust offs, and so the
do you
way
know what a bust off is,
I can imagine.
Can you?
I think I can. Unfortunately,
the way this would work would be no matter where we were, and whether it's no matter where we were, period, bar, party, dorm room, anywhere, when the song "Bust a Move" by Young MC came on, we immediately had to square off in a dance contest. Which I routinely won by jumping through my leg like Kid and Play.
Right, which we've established you right. can no longer do.
And and whoever was there present would judge. So if sometimes it would be at a party, and it got to the point where sometimes our friends would intentionally be like, you got to put Young MC on. Wait, you see what happens. But the crowd would usually choose a winner, and I would always save my last move. And I mean, it was a joke. Neither one of us could dance very well. But I would save the jump through the leg and win right. the bust off. But in certain instances bust where a winner could not be decided, the second song up was Good Vibrations by Marky Mark
come
and the
on,
Funky
come on,
Bunch.
Come on.
And that's how we broke the tie. And I think when the last bust off that I ever took a part of was in my own apartment. And my opponent was so sick of losing to me jumping through the leg that after I did the jump through the leg this time, I think I even pulled off the jump through the leg and jumped back through it.
Like the reverse.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
because
I needed up my game. But he then immediately had hidden an egg from the refrigerator.
A real live egg.
And he threw it against the ceiling and turned up down and let it drip into his mouth, and the crowd went nuts and I was defeated. I was defeated.
Defeated now, by the egg drop.
I later argued that was not a dance move, but at the end of the day, what is a dance move?
As long as the crowd is entertained, that's all that matters. Are you not entertained?
Not by an egg. Dripping
into
someone's
mouth. I
don't know.
In the moment at a wild party, someone tosses an egg up at the ceiling and gets wild at the end of a bust off, you might be entertained.
Good vibration.
Right.
Come on.
Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch. It's funny.
D-R-U-G-E, I'm anti. D-R-U-G, what was he saying? That doesn't even make sense. D-R-U-G-E, I'm anti?
Yeah,
he says D-R-U-G-E, I'm anti.
Druge.
Is that what he says?
Druge? No, I don't think so. I think he means that he's anti-drug.
You think he's still?
His,
or just that point in
say
his
hi to your mother for me.
His rhymes make him wealthy. And the Funky Bunch helps him do something, right?
It's so bad.
It just says,
one of the times that I laughed the hardest, I think, in my life was when Planet of the Apes came out. And the person I was going with was a former teacher. I went to see it with a former Miners Academy teacher. I had since graduated, I believe. And as we were going, he called it Marky Mark and the Monkey Bunch. And I laughed so hard at that. Because I thought it was the funniest joke I ever heard.
Was it a joke, or do you really think that?
No, it was funny because Mark Wahlberg's in the movie, and it's about a Planet of the Apes. So it was Marky Mark and the Monkey Bunch. I just thought that was funny.
I didn't know he was in the movie.
I thought it was a clever witticism.
It is funny. Here we go. Yo, it's about that time to bring forth the rhythm and the rhyme. I'ma get mine, so get yours. I want to see sweat coming out your pores. On the house tip is how I'm swinging this.
I see, I'd have to start from the beginning like this in order to get all the lyrics, but I know them.
Strictly hip-hop, boy, I ain't singing this. Bringing this to the entire nation, black, white, red, brown, feel the vibration.
It's such a...
But what I want to see is...
It's not come on, come on.
Come on, come on, come on. He does it after that.
Yeah, feel it, feel it.
Feel it, feel it. He was so jacked.
Remember that? I remember that.
He gets pissed when you ask him about it now.
I'm sure he does. It's ridiculous. It's a ridiculous...
But how can you be mad at it? It's what got you to where you are.
You can't be. He would be nothing without that.
That's what I mean. He's such a dickhead when people ask him.
Are there times in your life that you're just embarrassed of that you don't want? Well, it's like, look at the Beastie Boys. They weren't like super proud of their first couple things where they were talking about partying and guns and
but if those albums
they kind of
were never there,
the side.
If those albums,
I'm sure
they never did those albums.
I'm sure that they respected it and you know appreciated it, but they didn't want to talk about it anymore. They had moved on, do a new thing.
Donnie D's on the backup.
Donnie
drug
D.
free, so put the crack up.
That's right.
No need for speed. I'm the anti-druggie.
He's the anti-druggie.
Oh.
My body is healthy. My rhymes make me wealthy. And the Funky Bunch helps me to bring you a show with no intoxication. Those
guys weren't high.
It must be why I went with the people I went with.
You
I
have
went
to
with
be high.
Churchgoers.
Really?
Yeah.
Going like a church group to the Funky Bunch show?
We
Come
went
on,
to
we're gonna
go
see a group called the Funky
I also
Bunch.
Went and saw Jesus and the Amazing Technicolor or Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat with the same people.
What production of that? Who put it on?
No.
Was it at St. Patrick's Gymnasium? Because
no,
if
we
it was,
went somewhere.
I was one of the Joseph's brothers.
I think we went to Toronto or something.
You were jealous of his dreamcoat.
Our show did not go on the road.
You didn't make it?
No, it's to Toronto.
Come on, come on, come on.
Dan, do you got some choices for us here today or what?
Man, drink like...
Wait a minute.
You should choose the proper clip.
Yeah.
There we go. That's
Would you rather choose the proper clip? You got your notebook, Dandy?
Look at him right now. Don't need it tonight.
All right.
Something in my eye, though. All right. Would you rather be deaf with no legs?
Okay. Deaf, no legs. I got that.
Or blind with no arms?
<He's> so ridiculous. So
deaf with no legs or blind with no arms.
That's so hard. It's the hardest one you've ever proposed.
It's a hard one.
It is, Danny. You've done it.
And it has nothing to do with the deafness. It has everything to do with not having arms or
right.
not having
yeah.
legs.
Yeah.
No, blind and no arms.
It's tough.
Deaf and no legs. I think I would rather have legs. Well, you know what? You do so much with your hands. But the one thing they can't do for you is get you around unless...
You're in a wheelchair.
Yeah, or you developed a way to walk with your hands, which a lot of people do in that situation.
Yeah.
But you'd be deaf, right. So you'd have to... be able to hear because you wouldn't be able to see.
It's deaf with no legs?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I'd rather be deaf with no legs.
Oh, man.
Without a doubt. Because I would have my hands, I could see and still do things that I need to do.
Yeah, I'm going to agree with you. I don't like either option, but...
And the thing about being deaf with no legs is you can still use ASL and you don't have to, like... You can still speak to people. Because you can still use sign language. Because you have arms and not legs.
Either way.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Sight combined with arms and hands means you can really accomplish a lot of things, especially in this age of technology and computers.
And the other thing is, no arms is just weird looking. If you're walking around.
So with no legs, though.
And well, but you're also blind with no arms. You can't hold one of those canes to tap around.
No, you can't do anything. You can't feel people's faces.
You're just like a pole.
Exactly
you're just like
you
a pillar.
Are.
You're like a tube.
I think sight's everything. I'd always pick sight over anything else.
Yeah, because you can read lips.
Yeah. You don't see many guys with only two arms.
You can read lips.
Or with no arms,
sign.
I mean,
think
you
that's the money.
You don't see many guys that don't have two arms because there's not many ways to get afflicted with losing both
arms.
It's
hard to lose both arms, I think.
A lot harder than...
Do you have a favorite no-legged character in any movie?
Lieutenant Dan. I mean, that's where I go right away. But there are more.
He's definitely the best, though.
You mean no legs or just can't use your legs?
No legs.
What about the new question about the movies or whatever? A favorite no-legged character. Does it have to be no legs, or can it be just someone who can't use their legs?
No, no legs. Okay. Like Lieutenant Dan, no legs.
Dan, ice cream.
My favorite is
Craig Fox,
the black guy in Kids, when he's on the skateboard in the subway and he's shaking the bottom.
Yep.
I have no legs. And his shirt says, "Kiss me, I'm Irish."
That's a good one, Andy.
He's my favorite.
I haven't seen Kids in a long time.
It's the greatest movie ever.
No, it's the worst movie ever.
Don't worry, it's just Casper.
It's the worst movie ever. All right. So creepy.
So what did you decide?
I want to have my arms.
Yeah. What about you, Tony, sometimes? You went with arms?
Arms and eyes, yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely the way to go. It's not about what you don't have, it's what you do have. Arms and eyes. I want arms and eyes.
Yeah.
Do you have a choice?
Yeah, I want to be deaf with no legs.
Yeah, arms and eyes.
No, it's...
You want your arms and eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just
we
like
all
everyone
agree.
Else.
We all agree.
Yeah, that was easy.
That might be a first.
That was easier in the end than I thought it was going to be.
What do these guys want? Oh, these guys don't even care.
They want their eyes and arms.
They're fighting with each other.
Because they couldn't, they couldn't see our type.
Roger's deaf and no legs.
Of course.
Roger says you could get a cochlear implant in here again.
You could.
You can't pick
you can't,
these things.
Yeah, you can't manipulate it. Because then you could just get fake legs or fake arms.
Well, I would plan on it anyway.
You can't.
No, that's not part of the choice.
You can't do it. You'll never be able to get legs.
Well...
Then there's no sense in me even making these things up. If you guys are getting around it.
Right. That's true.
They can cure infantile AIDS now, so that's not even going to be a choice anymore.
What the hell is infantile AIDS?
Is that a choice?
Being born with AIDS?
Being born with AIDS, yeah.
That you can get rid of it?
There was a first confirmed case last week of a child. Well, didn't happen last week, but they
is it from
released
dead,
it last
dead
week.
Dead umbilical cord blood?
Magic nope. Johnson's kid.
So...
Mother had AIDS. Child was born with AIDS. And they gave it antiviral drugs, retroviral drugs. And then all of a sudden it went back for a checkup after so long it didn't have them anymore. Didn't have the AIDS.
Nothing against AIDS, but...
Nothing against it.
I mean...
It's a good disease.
It was made out to be like this horrible thing, but compared to other diseases, it doesn't seem that bad.
Not anymore. It's not.
It.
It's
you need to get on this cancer thing.
Used to be a life sentence.
In the beginning, it was ugly. You would deteriorate and have all these sores all over your body.
Like Pedro.
You should have been in San Francisco in 88.
Pedro was my first AIDS person.
He really brought it to the forefront.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Pedro Zamora, you're talking about?
AIDS wasn't big before that?
I don't think a lot of people...
He was high profile.
I mean, we live in a small
TV star.
Town, but...
We do? Oh, yeah, we do. We're deep beneath it right now.
Subterranean.
So you brought up the dried umbilical cord blood or whatever.
Cord blood.
If you had a child, would you pay the money to, like, freeze the dried umbilical cord blood to help your child if they ever got anything?
I didn't even think about that, so it's not something that we did.
I would if they asked me. Could I bring it home and keep it in the freezer?
Probably not, but it's expensive.
It shouldn't be, really.
It should just be a thing that they do.
Yeah.
There should be a cord bank.
Right. It should.
There
I agree.
But you have to pay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It should just be a service that's performed.
And what's so expensive about taking that thing
Nothing.
And freezing it and leaving it in a giant freezer?
Nothing.
It doesn't have to be a giant freezer. You can stack those things.
It's just
vacuum seal them, freeze them.
Yep.
I mean, you can vacuum seal things. Maybe that's a new business that I could start.
You should talk to P.
It's
Diddy.
Cold as it is. Up here
I was just going to say, it's
we
cold enough.
Keep it up here.
Just leave it in here.
Tony, sometimes in
cold?
P. Diddy, umbilical cord
My
freezing service.
You should see if you can get Mark Wahlberg on board, too.
P. Diddy.
I'll rent out my spare bedroom for cord blood.
It's a good idea. that won't be creepy. Come to Crazy Dandy's cord blood bank. It's in my spare bedroom.
Your cord will be safe for years to come in Dan's bedroom cord bank.
I terrible.
We could make a commercial and everything.
Yeah.
Sure.
It'd be awesome.
You're going to be swimming in money.
4th of July sale.
What's the sale?
Oh, we haven't heard this in forever. I love it.
Come on down to Dan's cord bank. We'll keep your cord nice and cold in my bedroom.
Your dog would be sniffing around that.
And if ever you should need it, just send Dandy an email.
Don't worry, your cord blood is protected from the dog by a baby gate. That's perfect.
The highest security available protect.
Baby gate.
Your umbilical cord blood.
Wow. Well, it's nice knowing you, Dandy.
You'd be rich.
Don't forget us when you're swimming all that cord blood.
You may need a bigger bedroom before long.
When I'm living on my island. Yep. Then we can use my whole house for the blood.
The only good thing is it's not. I don't think you have to keep that much.
No, you don't.
Just a little bit. I still got a little left over.
Still got a little black bit, do you?
That is so gross.
My mom was thinking ahead back then. Yep. Save that little kid.
Just leave him with a little nub on there.
Clip him long. You can use that scar tissue later.
Mm-hmm. Ew.
That's one way to do it. But I do agree with Saucy Joe. That should just be something that's done.
There's a lot of things that should be just done like that. But I'm not going to get too crazy on the show.
I agree with you for once.
I think we should store it on twice. The moon. That's twice today he's agreed with me.
Is the moon cold?
Oh, yes.
I think the space
cold,
is cold.
Very cold.
So there you go.
Yeah, there's no light up there.
Yeah, once it's up there, you got zero expense except for retrieval. You know, like
right.
You'd have to fish.
It's really inefficient way to store
for
cord
blood.
It's a really inefficient way. You'd have to trap. You'd pay
magnets,
billions of dollars to go get it. It would take a long time to go get.
Could you use magnets up in space?
Does it really take that long to get to the moon?
No.
Longer than you would want to take to go for treatment. You know,
if you could just jump in a rocket.
if someone needs cord blood, you're not going to be wanting to take a trip to the moon to get
it. Well, I would assume that if we are keeping our cord blood, that there'd be multiple people at a time. So, like, once a day you go up, you get, you know, person XY, 1, 2, 3. And
what if you need
the daily moon cord blood retrieval?
Yeah.
Shit, that's a good idea. Maybe we can have, like, a cord blood liaison halfway. They can just meet us. And
that's true.
The Russians.
Exchange, yeah.
All the money that you're saving on refrigeration costs, though, are offset by the cost of rocket fuel.
So much money to go get it.
You're always looking at the downside of things.
Wow.
Well, you know, the baby being cured of AIDS isn't the only thing in the news this week.
Why are you grimacing?
Am I?
Yeah, I saw it.
Dateline El Cajon, California. Man allegedly smears feces on car.
Dang.
It's one thing to smear a person's name, but it's another to smear your feces on their Toyota Camry. A man in El Cajon, California was arrested early this morning after officers say they observed him standing on top of the Camry smearing feces on it. When the cops approached the alleged poop smearer, they said he pulled on his shorts and jumped over a fence that separated the street from Interstate 8, according to hypervocal.com. Officials blame the suspect's annex for a crash that occurred and had to close westbound lanes. The suspect, whose name has not been released, was eventually apprehended at a trolley stop a short distance away from the crap-covered car, according to KGTV. KGTV-TV. Police are currently trying to figure out if the man was suffering from mental illness or was under the influence of drugs or alcohol. It's unclear what charges are pending. But, yeah. I don't often smear poop on a car, but when I do it in El Cajon.
Where do you find this stuff?
Internet.
Oh my god, I just saw the funniest picture on Facebook. I'm so sorry, but I have to share it.
Sure, point it right up there to the camera. Let's see if it focuses in.
Try harder. That picture earlier.
Try harder. Is that a baby?
It's a baby with a mustache.
I mean,
beard.
It's on Facebook. It must be a baby.
Or is that a man?
That.
Is that a deaf man with no legs?
What baby.
Is that? It's a baby dressed up to look like a man.
Is that Benjamin Button?
What is that?
Look at this. This is hysterical.
That's pretty funny. You're right. He's got a goatee, a baby goatee, which is funny.
And tattoos.
Dateline Jonesboro, Arkansas. Woman arrested for DWI tries to escape in toy truck.
Dang.
By the time police caught up with Jamie Jeanette Kraft, the 28-year-old woman had allegedly made her getaway in a battery-powered toy truck while not wearing any pants. The Jonesboro, Arkansas resident is accused of crashing her 2001 Pontiac Grand Am into a mobile home Sunday night, KAIT-TV reported. Witnesses say Kraft exited her car, got into a young boy's Power Wheels truck, and began to try to drive. When the child's father made her get out, she walked to her mom's house where police allegedly found her irate, intoxicated, and disorderly. Witnesses also told police that Kraft was wearing no pants or shoes when the accident occurred. Authorities say Kraft blew a .217 breathalyzer.
Wow. It's pretty far up there.
More than three times the legal limit, according to the KAIT website. Kraft faces charges of DWI and leaving the scene of an accident. So, how about that? Drunk woman rams her 2001 Pontiac Grand Am the size of a mobile home, jumps out and jumps into a toy truck and tries to escape that way. You got to be pretty drunk.
Power wheels.
And imagine you're this guy who was standing there and saw it all. You know, I think that's sometimes why I picked some of these stories is because I just imagine what that guy was who eventually, you know, made her get out of her Power Wheels, the Power Wheels truck.
Roger used to live right near El Cajon.
Ah. Oh. Land of mysteries.
El Cajon.
And for some reason, he knows that placenta is made into pills.
Sure. People grind it up. Dry it up. People make soup out of it, too.
I thought people planted trees over it.
People do that as well. People do a lot of things.
Don't they make shampoo with it?
People do a lot of crazy
things. People do a lot of crazy things with placenta.
Put it in shampoo.
Why would it be in shampoo?
I heard that once.
I think the tree thing is the most normal.
It's nourishing.
I think none of it's normal.
The tree thing, I think, is
what's not normal about it,
Danny? Normal. Because then your kid grows with the tree.
Just throw it away.
I mean,
it's gross.
What's not normal about it?
Well, you got the fucking baby in a little cradle in one hand and your garbage bag with your placenta in the other.
Yeah,
you walk out of the hospital.
It's not yours. It's just your lady friend's.
Right.
I mean, it's not mine, but...
Yeah.
I mean, compared to what's in the shampoo that you normally use,
that shit's not
it's really not that
car.
Much different.
I use Dove.
I use all-natural shampoo.
Doesn't matter what you use. That's probably even worse.
I use whatever one of the 5,000 bottles of shampoo my wife has in the bathroom.
So many.
You know,
and Dove's all-natural.
The worst part of it is like...
It just means there's real animal fat in it.
There's probably a 6-to-1 conditioner shampoo ratio in my shower.
So many bottles of conditioner.
Yeah.
Sometimes I can't find a bottle of shampoo.
Exactly. Very
and now there isn't any shampoo because my wife uses cleansing conditioner. When? Cleansing conditioner.
Oh, does she?
Oh, man. We're swimming in when. The baby uses when. James uses when. I use when.
Look at that. It's placenta and shampoo is the first thing that comes up.
No way.
Speaking of them, look at these little dandies.
Aww. That's cute. That.
Is that you and your brother?
No, that's my sons. My boys.
Is that you and your other man?
Is he wearing a bowl on his head?
No, he's got. It's like a little corduroy hat. He's like a newsie. 50 papes.
Like, that's exactly what you looked like when you were little.
That's why I just,
like,
that's
exactly.
Why I said it.
It's insane.
I know, no, this is my, we had, we
oh
went
my God,
to,
there's tons of shampoos with
we went
placenta.
To a portrait
name
studio.
Name some, I want to hear this. Let me see. I can. Oh.
Queen Helen placenta acid. Labella.
That sounds horrible. Placenta acid.
Eco.
They make water out
placenta
of that too.
Shampoo. Royal placenta
P.
shampoo.
He's got a water with that in there. Placentic acid, it's called.
Hask placenta, no rinse.
How much does it cost?
Wait, I don't understand why you'd
$7.
That's it?
It's not that bad.
You think it would be free.
Why? Do you think people, like, on their license say, all right, I'll donate my placenta to...
Well, I think they said
when they're pregnant.
I think that you just say flat, you can harvest my body for organs and placenta.
Yeah,
wait a second.
No,
wait.
But you, that's when you're dead.
Oh, yeah. Well,
you don't have a placenta if you just die.
No.
That's or if true. You're a man.
Only.
Well, not if you're Chaz Bono. I bet you he's got a placenta.
He does.
Charles.
Chaz.
Chaz is his man name?
Yeah.
Get with
it. I thought that was his girl name.
What do you
that
mean?
Chastity.
Chastity is his girl name.
Oh, whatever.
Chaz Titty.
Roger said titty. James has a huge head. I can dig it. I had a large head. Yep. I still have a large head. Yep.
He does.
James does have a big cabeza from El Cajon. Yeah, we had some portraits done.
Where'd you go? Well, no,
I don't even know. My wife had it done. I'm not really that thrilled with it all.
Why?
Yeah, I was going to say you better put the, I was going to say you better put the camera on this shit.
Putting lotion on my legs, they're dry.
All this placenta talk dried you out, huh?
If you had some placenta, it would really nourish your dry legs. Moisten it up.
I can't. Oh, good.
I just puked in my mouth.
I don't know. I dig the placenta tree thing, but nothing else.
You're probably washing your head with it.
There's no way.
Tell don't me. Be surprised.
I'm going to look at the ingredients when I go home.
It's time for the tweet of the week. This week's tweet of the week comes from Dan Gutterman. Breaking: 30 people feared soothed in a Yankee Candle fire. And from at the tweet of God: diamonds are a girl's best friend in an impoverished Sierra Leonean child laborer's worst nightmare.
That's funny.
Paulie always posted his favorite Twitter today.
Oh, did he?
You didn't see it?
No.
How do I find it now?
Where'd that come from? Search for Paulie always on Twitter. Or on either one, yeah.
Is he Paulie? I don't know his name. I don't even know how to find people on this stupid thing.
I'm bad at Twitter.
You're bad at it? What do you mean? Like you just mess it up?
I'm just not good at
I can't do this. The UI on Twitter is not very good. Like when you want to search for somebody specific, it's a little harder than maybe Facebook or...
It's from Jose Canseco. And it says, Dennis Rodman, if you need my help with anything, let me know. You're on the right path.
I saw that. That was that funny.
Wasn't Dennis Rodman just hanging out with Kim Sung Hoo or something like that?
Yeah, that's who it is.
It was him and Kim Sung Hoo. Yeah.
Some young guy.
But didn't he call him Barack Obama?
No, they were talking about Barack Obama, supposedly.
Rodman was trying to get, they were trying to get a meeting together with Barack Obama and the leader of Korea, North Korea.
Kim Sung Hoo.
Because I really think if Barack Obama was going to listen to anyone, it'd probably be Rodman. Dennis Rodman.
Yeah.
Is he still all fucked up?
Yeah.
According to Dr. Drew.
Oh, and that guy knows. That guy's got his game together. Freaking HLN.
Yeah. Not even. He's got his own show on whatever network that is.
Terrible.
Does he really?
I think that Kim Jong-un was a massive Dennis Rodman fan is what it was when he was younger. No, I'm serious.
Yeah, he's an NBA fan.
Right? He was a big NBA fan. He loved Dennis Rodman. So he, like, idolized Dennis Rodman.
So he allowed...
Yeah, I mean, Dennis Rodman was cool 15 years ago, but...
Yeah, when
isn't
Kim
that
Jong-un
some sort of,
boy.
Like, treason, though, for an American to go over there?
No.
No? Probably should be,
you can
though.
Do whatever you want in this world as an American, pretty much.
Well, no.
You can't go to Cuba.
Cat Stevens couldn't do whatever
that's
the hell
true.
He did.
He could. He just
wasn't allowed.
Had
back.
The same name as someone else who, unfortunately, was a suspected terrorist.
Is that what happened?
Yeah,
that's what he gets for changing his name.
Yeah, well,
stick with your first one, Cat.
If you change your name to Yusuf Islam, you're gonna have a bad time.
It's not gonna work out well for you.
I listen.
Wait,
to some
so you can't get
today.
So I like me and you could go over to North Korea.
We're gonna have a bad time.
Why? We just say we're friends with
we're
Dennis
not
Dennis Rodman.
Yeah, well, hey, I'm Dennis Rodman.
Then when he checked up and found out we were lying, we'd be probably stoned in the public square.
They would say, Brother wait Wee's a minute, you don't look like Dennis Rodman.
Brother Wee said Dennis Rodman's an asshole.
I believe that.
I would agree, probably. I don't really know him personally, but I bet he is.
I bet
you. He met him at some club or some shit.
8 out of 10 people that know Brother Wee say he's an asshole.
Oh, no.
Whoa.
I strongly disagree.
Okay. You're in the two people that don't.
He's beloved.
Yeah, I think he's an all-around good guy.
I think
he's
beloved.
Everybody's got someone who thinks they're an asshole.
I'm sure someone, but I don't think 8 out of 10 or whatever he said.
All right, fine. It's just you like your opinion, man.
Yeah,
I mean,
Google it.
It's just
see if that's on psychologytoday.com. If that says anything about that.
Everybody has their morning show people. Brother Weege just isn't Saucy Joe's.
I don't have any morning show people. I'm not a morning.
Why don't you like him?
Huh? Why don't you like him?
I didn't say I didn't like him. I just said that I bet you a lot of people think he's an asshole. I didn't say I thought he was an asshole. Four-fifths. Four-fifths. Is what I said. Of people.
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
Eight-tenths.
Right. Four-fifths.
Two and two-halves.
What the fuck are you talking about? Oh, man. Danny's had too much hard cider.
I gotta go home. It's Tuesday. I'm usually sleeping by now on Tuesday.
Really?
Yeah.
Time? No way. You out of your mind?
He gets up early, 4:30 or something.
How do you watch Justified?
I don't watch that show.
That's crazy.
Do you watch The Americans?
No, I haven't watched it yet. I have it recorded. I haven't watched it yet.
No.
Nope.
I'm learning a lot about Soviets.
Are you? Through Kerry Russell?
Through Fox.
Thanks, Kerry Russell.
It's better than freaking going to school.
Yeah, it's probably that show probably gives you a pretty accurate historical perspective of the
Cold War era.
Yeah, and the coexistence of the two superpowers of the world in the...
It's got to be true. It's on TV.
It's true. I'll
tell you what else true is this, what's coming across right now on the international newswire.
Speaking of the Cold War...
Dateline, London, England. British Batman turns out to be Stan the Delivery Man.
Dang.
It wasn't Batman, it was a Joker. A day after making headlines around the world for handing over a suspect to police dressed as Batman, the identity of Britain's mysterious escape crusader has been revealed as Stan, a takeaway food delivery man. That's what they say in Britain.
Takeaway food.
Yeah, not whatever we call it.
I think these people that dress up like superheroes are assholes.
And then turns them into the police? Police in Bradford, Northern England were baffled when a portly figure in an ill-fitting Batman costume brought them a 27-year-old man wanted for burglary in the early hours of February 25th before disappearing into the night. They released closed-circuit television footage of the incident on Monday, and after much speculation, the masked hero was disclosed his true identity to media on Tuesday. He was not Batman's alter ego Bruce Wayne, but driver Stan Warby, 39. He also said he had not brought the man in as part of any crime-fighting crusade. He had simply agreed to accompany a friend to the police station to offer him moral support and had decided to wear the Batman suit as a practical joke. Obviously, it was done as a joke, he told ITV's Daybreak program, saying he was gobsmacked by the attention.
That's another thing they say across the pond. Gobsmacked.
Werby said he had been to London's Wembley Stadium earlier in the day to watch a local Bradford City team play in the English Capital One League Soccer Cup final and had worn the fancy dress for the occasion. While there, Werby was contacted by a friend and agreed to take him on his return from London. Obviously, he wanted to get straight down there, and I wanted my bed as it was 1:30 in the morning. So there you go. It was a case of
1:30.
Yeah,
he was just drunk.
Time to get your head down for a kip, you know what I mean?
Why do they always have to dress up? Just
fancy dress?
Fight crime without dressing up.
Superheroes?
Haven't you ever seen Superbad?
Dandy, do you want to know why?
Because they're children.
They want to maintain their anonymity. No.
That's not why.
You're right.
It's one of the main reasons.
People always find out who the fuck they are.
No, they don't.
Yeah, if it's Stan Warbly, the delivery man, he's a bungling idiot.
Every superhero story we've heard on this show, we've known the guy's name.
You're talking about superheroes, though.
Yeah, I'm talking about these jerks.
I thought you were talking about real superheroes. You know, real superheroes. I was gonna get crazy on you right now.
No, like these guys that go out at night and fight crime, all dressed up like jackasses. Why can't you just wear a pair of jeans and a fucking hoodie?
Because it's more noteworthy if you dress up as Batman. It's hilarious. Especially, did you see the pictures of this guy? It's the most ridiculous costume you ever
saw.
Too
small.
I'm not going to lie. If you were out at night and I was doing something wrong and you were going to, like, citizens arrest me,
yeah,
I would go more calmly if you were dressed normal than if you were dressed like Batman.
I wouldn't dress like Batman.
If you were dressed like Batman, I would probably try to fight you.
I would pick a better...
I don't think you'd go calmly, period.
I would pick somebody else.
I definitely wouldn't go calmly if you were dressed like a superhero. Like, if the Red Power Ranger came at me in the middle of the night,
shit's going down. Power Rangers aren't superheroes, and I wouldn't go as a Power Ranger anyway. If I was going to go with someone like that, it would be one of the Voltron team.
You wouldn't be able to catch me. You'd be a big fucking...
Hell, I wouldn't. I'd have an awesome mechanical lion. Whatever, Dandy.
You'd be a big robot. You go ahead and catch me.
Go ahead and try me.
I can outrun you.
You can't outrun Voltron. You're hilarious. You have no idea.
Unless you're the yellow stingray, you
Defender
can't catch me.
Defender of the universe.
If I could be one superhero, it would be Superman, without a doubt. One thing can stop you. Kryptonite. You guys ever seen any kryptonite around here? No.
I got some.
It only comes from the planet Krypton.
I could fly anywhere without an airplane.
Ironically, the place of his birth.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure if I started firing cord blood at you, it'd take you out.
That would be a superhero power. He'd have an infinite supply of cord blood.
He's been collecting it for years as part of a front for his business.
Just frozen cord.
That's gross. You're weird.
Like little chunks of
ice
cubes.
You could be called Captain Umbilical. That's what I would call you.
Placenta mate.
Placenta.
I almost laughed before I said it.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I've got something to recommend this week to improve the lives of our users.
I do too.
I go last.
Well. This week, I am going to recommend kale. It's a leafy substance.
So
kale is
good. No, it's incredible.
It's his recommendation. Let him go.
I make the best kale ever. I would have brought it in.
Kale is fantastic. It's not a leaf I've gone to until recently. I like to saute it in a little butter.
Nope.
It's got a sweet taste to it. I like to eat it raw, chopped up with a little... You know, a little olive oil and salt and pepper and maybe some pine nuts. That's good.
That sounds good.
But mostly sauteing that in butter and putting it. I made it on Sunday, made a little lasagna, and also made some kale with butter beans and roasted red peppers sauteed in butter.
Sounds good.
And I made some other dish a couple weeks ago where I put the kale underneath the fish or something.
What do you do with kale?
Isn't frying it up in butter kind of defeating the purpose, though?
Of having it taste good? I'm not eating it because it's health
perfect.
Food. It is healthy.
Yeah, but that's what kale's for, like to be healthy.
No, it's just a
it's just food.
For eating.
It is a superfood. You're right.
Yeah.
It's a superfood.
But it's not. That's not what it's for. I mean, it's a food. It's for eating. If you want it to taste delicious, go ahead.
Yeah, but it's better than any other lettuce or green you're going to
I can
go
eat
for.
A chicken breast
it's the same as you guys
and have it be
cream
healthy.
And sugar in your coffee.
Or I could maybe have
it's my
a
treat.
Yeah, well, sauteing that in butter.
But I'm saying you can get like lettuce for cheaper.
It's
so you're paying for kale for
name
at that point.
No.
You're putting butter on it.
Kale
is putting butter on it, so you're taking everything away.
So you think if I sauteed lettuce and butter that would be have the same result?
Well, listen to me.
It wouldn't. It wouldn't, Danny.
Kale is much better for you. Putting butter on it doesn't make it any less nutritious.
Just
adds certainly
fat.
Adds cholesterol and fats to it.
And flavor.
But it doesn't take away.
Don't
and
forget,
certainly flavor.
Don't forget
most
the flavor.
Importantly, flavor.
Salt right, and pepper.
As I wave my hand like an Italian.
Does it make you shit green?
No, but you should put...
I'll tell you what it does. Fruit Loops.
Yeah, any
Holy
cereal that with flavor, yes.
I had 3 bowls of Fruit Loops in the past 2 days, and man.
Like green
machine.
Like
green.
Like little kid green?
Yeah. Like Fruit Loops green.
I don't know. I don't eat Fruit
All
Loops.
The colors mixed at once.
I'm an adult.
Like. A lot of dyes. That's probably what my whole insides are colored like.
Dye number 4, dye number 7, dye number 8, 13.
Remember when they used to say the yellow 5 Mountain Dew would make your penis small?
Now you have to use red wine vinegar in your kale.
I do. So I did actually when they made that bean dish, I sprinkled some red wine vinegar on
it.
The end.
Make it not so tough.
You want to know what my wife does with kale?
Let's hear it.
She uses it in beans and greens in place of...
Yes.
I do the same thing with...
It's good. It's a little tougher, but it is really good.
It's crunchy.
But if you add shrimp to it,
shrimp?
So it's like a brothy shrimp, it's really good.
Holy smokes, you better
spicy.
Talk to my wife
you
about that.
You can't go wrong with kale. What do you recommend, Dandy?
You don't make friends with kale, Dandy.
I had something, but I forgot. Coupons.
Classic Dandy. Yeah, coupons.
I went grocery shopping Sunday night.
How much did you save?
I
coupons.
Before my coupons and my Topps Club card, it was $84. Guess how much it was after.
61. Lower?
No way.
I believe it. Couponing is unbelievable. My wife is on it now.
Well, plus everything's 50. Overpriced unless you have that.
Lower?
I saved 50%.
Holy
$41 from 84.
You should have a
fucking unbelievable. Couponing I wanted to bring class. My.
You could have got twice as many groceries.
I wanted to bring my receipt in, but I forgot.
That's a good one. That's a good recommendation.
I got my mom a dollar in gas.
Thrifty.
That's right. The gas is. I know where you're shopping.
Tops.
Yeah.
I said I used my
friendly
Tops
markets. Yeah. Well, you. I don't carry the card. I type into my phone number into the thing and get the discount. But, yeah, everything's overpriced unless you get the discount.
Right.
So
it was awesome. I felt so good about myself when I was
how much of
it.
That
like
was
I, like I got
how
that,
much
like,
was a coupon
I
savings?
Bet you,
the
bet
coupons.
You
how many coupons?
I think the coupons were like 24, 25.
Yeah. That's good, man. That's yeah. Half.
I never, ever used
coupons.
A lot of
buy one, get one frees.
BOGO.
I don't even cash in restaurant gift cards when they're given to me many times.
Really?
I don't know why.
I usually do, but it's like the day before it expires.
Yeah, you got to get out there and take care of it. Well, good one, Danny.
Saucy Joe, what do you recommend this week?
I'm going to recommend the War Horse Brewfest this weekend, Saturday, starting at noon at Three Brothers Winery. $20. Noon to 5 or noon to 6.
Watch the horses war with each other.
You so. Sample all their beers and wines. From Three Brothers, and also participating breweries like Roosterfish and other places.
Hmm.
Custom brew crafters.
What time does that start?
Noon.
Fancy.
$20.
Get messy.
I'm recommending it.
Mysterious Taco Girl, what do you recommend?
I'm going to recommend not using water bottles and using reusable water containers.
Oh, I see. So you're recommending using reusable water containers.
Yep.
How come?
Oh, I see.
Because every second U.S. consumers use or dispose of 1,500 plastic water bottles.
Every second?
Every second.
That's think crazy. Of that. Boosh, boosh,
boosh. You know what I mean? That's
a noise.
That's the sound of 1,500 water bottles hitting landfills across the country.
That's unbelievable.
Every second.
That's a lot of water bottles.
My yeah, water bottles don't go to the landfill.
They get recycled and made into
you'd
pens.
You'd be surprised how much of that goes to the landfill in the end.
Really?
Yeah. You should really use a
recycling program, isn't
it? For $7.99, you can get this at Dick's Sporting Goods. And it'll save you a ton of money on bottled water.
Is that a Coleman you got there?
I don't know how to say it. You always say
Nalgene, it. Nalgene, right?
Yeah.
Hmm.
It's the only way. Well, it's not the only way, but I try
I
to drink my water.
I have a SIG downstairs. Swedish.
Yeah.
It's metal.
They're nice, too.
Yeah. I actually like the taste that the metal
the
gives
metal,
it.
I yeah. don't.
I got one
I
of those,
to
that
the
kind, too. SIG. From the Marlboro Ranch.
Yeah, nice.
It's a red one.
Tobacco.
But that's spelled C-I-G-G instead of S-I-G-G because it's from the Marlboro Ranch. See what I did there? SIG.
You know what you would
wordplay.
Don't want to do with those metal ones?
What?
Put water in them and put them in the freezer and let them freeze.
Yeah, not a good idea.
They explode.
It'll
oh, do they really?
Sure.
These don't. At least they don't in my car when I leave them overnight.
Ice takes up more space than water,
it's
I
true.
Guess.
It gets bigger.
I
as
guess.
It freezes, yeah.
Science.
It's all true.
I saw that on Mr. Wizard back in the day.
Sure.
Oh, the best Mr. Wizard was when he fucking put the match in the bottle and sucked the egg in. I was amazed for years.
That's a good one.
That is a good question.
I could never figure it out.
How about when he made the homemade ash snakes? You ever see that one?
Just little
he made
pellets?
A, yeah, but he made a like a soup can sized one. It was incredible.
That was the best show on Saturday morning.
That was a good one. That guy was awesome.
He's dead now, right?
Sure.
Americans add 29 billion water bottles a year. Landfills.
That's the noise of 29.
That's not even a bottle a person. It's not bad.
A day
just Americans,
or a year?
Just Americans.
A year, she said.
Hmm. Yeah, that's not bad.
What do you mean?
How many is it? 29 million?
Billion.
Billion.
Oh,
yeah, that's
billion?
Way
billion.
More than one. Yeah, that's
said
a lot.
Million.
It's an awful lot.
Yeah, that sucks, people. Come on.
And in order to make these bottles, manufacturers use 17 million, million with an M, barrels of crude oil. That's enough oil to keep a million cars going for 12 months.
Wait, so is your bottle made out of my recycled bottles?
No.
The thing is, that's also made it with petroleum.
Yeah, but this one lasts me.
I know. I'm just
for
saying.
Years.
It's also made with petroleum. Everything is.
Go to Dick's.
Plastic is unbelievable.
Buy yourself a reusable water bottle.
Or just use a cup.
Yeah, but you can't like go like this with a cup.
You can, but you'll get wet. You can do that.
You can do whatever you want with a
but
cup.
You can, but you won't save your water.
You can take a cup to North Korea and do that if you want to.
With Kim Sung-hoo.
Yep.
Well, any parting shots?
Yeah. Don't drink 2 10-packs of Capri Sun in one weekend.
Well, I'm glad you brought that up, actually, because you know something? They recently discovered in Capri Suns, you know, you drink a Capri Sun, you never see what you're drinking.
Guess who does?
How'd
you vomit?
No, because I cut them up and I put them into a pint glass.
That's smart because
I saw this.
Yeah,
freaked out now.
A lot of Capri Suns have mold. Not a lot, but a fair number have been reported have mold in them, and the fruit juice turns colors, and it's apparently not harmful to your health, but it's pretty disgusting.
Good.
It's pretty disgusting, and does it? I don't know if it changes the taste all that much because apparently the news thing I saw
it was like they said it was bitter and sour.
Huh.
And they cut it open and dumped it into a cup, and it was like sludgy. Murky water.
Ugh.
No, the pouch delivery system was bound to fail.
So I cut mine and put them in a pint glass. But don't drink 20 of them in one weekend.
Why? What happens?
Every time I drink one, I get a headache. Just one single one.
That's You've great. Ruined yourself yeah. on Capri Sun.
It might also be because I can only drink them in one sip every time.
The whole thing.
The whole thing.
The whole thing. Every pouch.
I can't stop
myself.
It's
another downfall of the pouch delivery system.
You can't
you
save
when
any.
You're getting low, yeah.
Oh, you know.
Well, when there's not that much in there anyways. I've never needed to save my Capri Sun.
They're just one-shotters.
Yeah, they're not that good either, I don't think.
My mom buys them for me because they're like fucking 10 for $5 or some shit.
Extreme couponing.
Yeah, we got Capri Sun in the fridge at home right now.
I'm going to drop 5 or more boxes off at your house tomorrow.
But, yeah, that was in the news this week, too. Any other parting shots?
Mm-mm. Go Blue.
Yeah.
Yeah, Minders basketball playing Lions tomorrow night in Rochester, the Blue Cross Arena. Winner goes on to face Sugar Creek from Buffalo Section 6.
How many goddamn games do they got to win before
they
make it to
so
states? Jesus Christ.
Well, no, listen, this is how it works.
It's pretty complicated.
Take it from a guy who knows. On Saturday, they had the sectional championships in Blue Cross. And in Class C, there's 3 divisions, C1, C2, C3. Minders won C1, Lions won C2, Clyde won C3. So now Section 5 needs to determine a representative from Class C to go on to the state tournament. So Lions had the most sectional points. They got a bye. Minders played Clyde, which is pretty incredible. Happened on Monday night. Minders won. Now they play Lions tomorrow night, which is also pretty incredible because they're 2 local communities that Minders doesn't play very often. And then the winner goes on to play in Buffalo for the right to go to Glens Falls. And then once they're there, they need to win 2 more games to be state champions.
3 games.
So they're 4 games away now.
Has it always been this many games, though? Like when the teams from Minders before, didn't they only have to play like 2 or 3 games?
Well, yeah, but that meant it was harder to win sectionals to begin with because there was less divisions. But like in Class B, there's B1 and B2.
All right, yeah. Yeah, because when I was in school, there was no this C1, C2, C3 bullshit. It was A, B, and C, and that was it.
Yeah, I don't understand it now.
It's all very confusing.
It is.
The world of high school basketball.
So, say they go...
Only a few, select few can understand it. It's just really complicated.
Say they go to the finals.
Yep.
Anyone here going?
I am.
I'm going
really?
Up tomorrow night. Finger Lakes want to be live tweeting that business.
Why, you want to go?
I mean, it might be interesting.
We can fill our
bathtub
with beer.
To go to Glens Falls?
I know, right?
Fill
like
our
old school?
With beer. Maybe have sex with a coach or something.
I mean, you can.
All right, Danny. All right, sounds good.
So, well.
You're going to have sex with a boys basketball coach somewhere?
No.
All right. Coach, you said it, not me.
Coach Mike Fields of the Myers County Blue Devils.
How long has he been the coach? I saw a picture the
about
other day.
10, yeah, I'd say yeah, close to 10 years
is
now.
Is it really?
Yeah, maybe not quite 10, but he's done a good job.
Who was the coach when we were in school?
I don't know. How do I know from basketball?
No, was it Near Pass?
Yeah, probably for a little while.
Yeah, yeah. That sounds about right. Yeah. I don't know anything from basketball, coach.
As a girl used to player, go to the games, I knew the boy players.
You used to go to the games, though.
Sure I did. We had
you were all pie-eyed, though, huh?
No, we had Finnish Wonder, Miko, El Silta.
Oh, that's right.
We used to go and support him.
Have you seen him lately?
Miko and EJ. Yeah, actually, I saw him.
How's he doing?
I didn't see him recently. I saw him a couple years ago. We went to dinner with him when he comes home or here.
I feel like I went to that dinner. Did we go to the Deer Head?
We went to the Deer Head. You went with us.
And I didn't even really know him, but I somehow...
When was that?
Was involved
in that. This is not pertinent information for anyone watching the show, by the way.
It's too bad you guys had to go ahead and... go off on that tangent because now we don't have time to talk about the behavioral sink by Will Wales, but perhaps another time. Till then, send us some email, info@thesaucepod.com. We'll read that on the air, specifically Dandy Will. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter, Stitcher, iTunes, YouTube. Damn, Sauce Pod's everywhere, y'all.
Thanks for listening.